What's going on, everybody? I hope you're all well, and welcome back to Dragon Age Awakening. Here we are back in the main hall for Vigil's Keep. We do have our companions here. This is our new little hub. Instead of the party camp, we have the throne room. We do have a lot of people to talk to find out kind of what some of the political intrigue in Amaranthine is like. Now, you've got to imagine, given that this is Alhau's old Aldum, a lot of his subjects were probably quite on board with the things that he was doing. Maybe some of them even agreed with him politically. I'm sure Loghain, given that he used to be a legend, has a lot of faithful people here, so I'm not expecting smooth sailing. I'm sure somebody's going to try and stick a knife in our back somewhere along the line. Talk to our mistress, captain, and Seneschal Barrel here.
Warden Commander, a pleasure to meet you. I'm Mistress Wolsey, sent by order of the First Warden at Whiteheart. I'm to act as treasurer of the Arling of Amaranthine. He believed local men could not be trusted for this post.
One of those local men is right here, Mistress Wolsey.
I have every confidence in the Vigil's loyalty in the matter of arms. But gold corrupts even the most resolute soul.
I had no idea that Weishaupt had treasurers. You're from Weishaupt?
Not Weishaupt itself. I'm from many places. I go where the wardens command. Sir, the Arling is on the brink of economic collapse. Trade must flow. Merchant caravans are being systematically attacked somewhere along the Pilgrim's Path. It is the only route that can reliably provision an army, feed a city, and maintain civilization.
How do I deal with this?
In the city of Amaranthine, there is a trader, Mervis, whose caravans have been hit particularly hard. He may know where along the road the Darkspawn, or whatever they are striking.
We will certainly go take care of that. The regular people here don't deserve economic collapse because of Alhau. The First Warden sent only a treasurer. I need more wardens.
The Ferelden's are a proud people. They are proud of you, especially. Had the First Warden sent foreign fighters, it would have caused great distrust amongst the locals. Barrel was specifically chosen as Seneschal because he commands great respect here.
Why does the First Warden care about Amaranthine?
About the Arling? He does not. But about the implications? A great deal. When Warden Commander Dryden was cast out of Ferelden generations ago, it created a dangerous precedent. Her true story, and that of the Warden's exile, is one you yourself uncovered at Soldier's Peak, at great personal risk. We are now presented with another precedent. Wardens owning lands and commanding fealty from lesser nobles. If your Arling succeeds, it will be an example to other kingdoms that wardens are important, blight or no.
I'm inclined to agree. Sophia Dryden almost cost Ferelden its entire future. A little rebellion cost the wardens their right to exist here, basically, which almost cost Ferelden its entire existence. If she hadn't done what she did, I still maintain that the blight at Ostagar would have been met with hundreds of wardens very well equipped. Have you ever been to Weishaupt?
No. It is far to the north. The fortress is said to be impregnable. It still has the areas where the griffins of old would breed, but their like will never be seen again.
That will be all, Mistress Wolsey.
Very well, Commander.
We're definitely going to check out the merchant situation. Trade is essential. Doesn't matter how good our standing army is, if we can't make coin, this place is doomed nonetheless.
Commander?
This is Sir Garavel, the new captain of the guard.
I have a matter to bring to your attention.
What do you know about the Darkspawn attack on the Vigil?
My predecessor, Captain Rullins, and much of the senior staff were inside the keep proper at the time. How they met their fates is unknown. All we know is Darkspawn swarmed the keep.
Where did the Darkspawn come from?
I talked with the dwarf Voldric earlier. It's his belief, and I concur, that they came from the keep itself. The deep cellars go very deep indeed. Voldric suspects the Darkspawn found a hidden route into the keep.
How many soldiers survived the attack on the Vigil?
Barely any, truth be told, and none of the wardens. But there are many soldiers still out patrolling the roads between here and Amaranthine. We can recover from this.
The Darkspawn leader talked. I heard him.
That is disturbing, Commander. But all throughout the lands we've heard rumors. Tales of new Darkspawn. Terrifying ones, forged out of nightmare and shadow. Something grave is afoot.
Those rumors about Torquin Darkspawn started right after we killed the Archdemon. Can we change the subject?
Certainly.
Anything important?
Potentially urgent. The Orlesians, wardens, I mean, began gathering information while they were here. The most promising lead they found was a wild tale a couple of hunters told.
What did the hunters claim?
These hunters, Colbert and, well, the other one, claimed to have stumbled across an entrance to the Deep Roads. Darkspawn all over the place, they said. And this was before the fiends appeared throughout the whole Arling. The wardens were just about to send someone to track down Colbert.
Back into the depot. Those hunters may have found the Darkspawn breeding ground.
One breeding ground, at least. Colbert and his friend are in the city of Amaranthine. Probably amongst the refugees outside the city gate. Commander.
Well, it seems like all roads are leading to Amaranthine right now. But you, Varl?
To business, then. Orlais sent a dozen wardens to the vigil to await your arrival. Nearly all died in the attack, but Christoph is still in the field.
Where is this, Christoph?
The Orlesian wardens were uneasy that the Darkspawn weren't going to ground with the Blight ended. Christoph was sent to track down some leads. A fortnight ago, he left in a bustle. As best we figure, he went to the city, Amaranthine.
Amaranthine isn't small. How will I find him?
Only so many places travelers visit. I check the inns and taverns.
Okay. Did Christoph reveal anything of what he found?
He did, but not to me. The wardens keep their own counsel.
That's true, but not exactly the most transparent order. Why aren't the Darkspawn returning to the Deep Roads?
Wiser men than I have worried over that. One of the wardens said the Archdemon's strength gave the Horde some semblance of purpose. If they found some other purpose...
Is there anything else? Or can we talk of other matters?
That's the only thing that needs immediate attention. Do you want something else, Commander?
What does a Seneschal do?
As much as you like, sir. Generally, the Keep's Seneschal takes care of day-to-day matters. If anything important arises, I'll alert you.
Can you tell me about Vigil's Keep?
We call her the Vigil. She's been around for a long spell. They say the Alamari barbarians first built a fort here to stop Tevinter incursions from the lowlands of the Waking Sea. They say that the castle is built on a mountain of bones. Much death here.
I expect to see the Vale weak then. Farewell. Alright, and that has given us our main plot quests. Now, before we head on and take care of any of that, I do want to make a quick swing. I'm not going to talk to the companions just yet.
Mistress Woolsey says I can set up shop here. The merchant you saved was grateful to be alive. Restock me for a bargain. The savings are yours, of course. You need anything, Commander?
Like I said, it never hurts to have a merchant in your pocket. Let me see what you have. Alright, now of course we're going to be buying all the health potions. I'm sure they'll come in handy. I am going to go ahead and clean up my inventory and sell a bunch of things here, so I'll cut the video. I'll catch you guys if I see anything interesting. He does have two backpacks, actually, so we'll go ahead and get the Manual Shadow. You don't see me, but that doesn't mean I'm not here. A maudlin tale of a rogue growing up in a loveless home. We'll go ahead and take that, of course. Seems like a skill tome. We'll definitely take any new specializations they have to offer us. And we have rune tracings. Let's craft our own runes. Our mages do have the ability to do that. Right, and there's a specialization unlocked, Shadow. Now, we do have a level up. What it does Shadow do for us? Specialization bonus, plus 1 dexterity, plus 5 attack. There is no order of organization of Shadows. They are self-taught elite rogues, masters of concealment and ambush. They strike from darkness, employing personal decoys and hallucinogenic poisons to distract enemies before sliding a dagger between their ribs. What is Legionnaire Scout? Most tales of the Dwarven Legion of the Dead are likely minstrels' fabrications, but the trail of darkspawn corpses that the Legion leaves behind proves the efficacy of their training. Legionnaire scouts can often travel ahead of their companions and have consequently become renowned for unusual hardiness, able to survive battles that would kill any other rogue. This seems like Shadow is going to be more the thing for us. Let's go on down the line and see what Shadow has to offer us. I'll likely go ahead and boost my stamina, honestly, given all the things that we have. Now, where's Shadow? Shadow form. While this mode is active, the shadow flits in and out of concealment. Because enemies cannot concentrate on the character, each hit reduces their interest in the attacker. This mode consumes stamina continuously. We have Decoy. The shadow is a master of misdirection, creating a personal decoy that keeps enemies occupied for a short time while the actual character escapes in stealth. Shadow Striking, which is a passive. The shadow has become more experienced in ambush and deception, gaining a large bonus to backstab damage while using shadow form, as well as permanent bonus to melee critical chance. And then the last is Pandemonium. The shadow releases an airborne toxin that confuses all enemies within range, causing them to either flee or attack a random target, whether friend or foe. Okay, so I'm definitely interested in leveling up this line. We'll go ahead and grab the first one. I'm gonna put the shadow abilities over here so I don't activate them by accident. Somebody else new over here with Ambassador Sarah.
The Tower of Magi has sent me as an ambassador, Commander. In addition to my diplomatic function, I'm a competent enchanter and runesmith. Is there anything you need?
Interesting, so Irving sent her. And this Amaranthine has its own circle, but I doubt so, since it's Ferelden's circle, not Redcliffe's circle. Yeah, Battle Mage manual, we'll definitely be grabbing that. Okay, so you get two of the subclasses instantly for free. Now, before we talk to the companions, I do want to explore the castle a little. Because I do know that we have companions we can grab, so...
Let's get started.
Yes.
We still don't have a full complement.
Blimey, Commander of the Grey. Right. A while back, they caught a thief in the vigil. Took four wardens to capture him. Gave one of the wardens a black eye, he did. Half joking, they said he might make a good recruit.
Where is this thief now?
He's in the dungeon, sir. I also have some letters. Arrived just before you did.
Show them to me.
Just give me a moment.
A daughter ransomed. Commander of the Grey. I am Sir Edgar Bensley, a faithful vassal. My daughter and sole heir, Eileen, has been kidnapped by Mosley the Snake's vile lot of miscreants. My fief is small, and my means meager, and they have demanded 30 sovereigns in a time frame I cannot meet. I pray you will intercede on my behalf. The ransom is to be delivered to the abandoned chantry by Forlorn Cove. If you produce the ransom, I swear by my faith in Andraste that I will repay you in time. You and my gentle daughter go with my prayers. Sir Edgar Bensley. We will for sure be checking that out, but I can promise you one thing. We won't be paying any scumbags 30 sovereigns. They'll be handled a different way. Barfield. Most honored commander. Ever since my husband passed, I've been looking after my family and the hired hands. But the darkspawn have been getting worse. We've a Templar who checks on us occasionally, but there's a limit to what he can handle. If you can help my family, we'll tell Lord Edelbreck you're a friend. I fear we may not have much time. Good wife, Valena Turnoble. We will certainly go and investigate that too. They had me at Darkspawn, so we'll be going to check those things out. Now, dungeons. Where are the dungeons? Sergeant Mavalis. We'll go ahead and talk to her in a little. I'll check out these dungeons first. Gotta get ourselves acquainted with the keep.
Ah, Commander. Good thing you're here. This one's been locked up 3 nights now. Good men died while this one was protected in his cell.
Well, that's hardly his fault. Who is he?
He won't give his name. All I know is he was caught poking around the estate in the middle of the night. I'd say he was just a thief. But it took 4 Grey Wardens to capture him. You best be careful. Whoever he is, he's no ordinary burglar, that's for sure.
Well, it seems like he wasn't interested in hurting people. And if it took 4 Wardens to catch him, then he was definitely capable. Leave me to talk with him.
As you wish, Commander. I'll tell the Seneschal you came. He'll want to know what you decide to do with this man.
Prisoner's effects. The bear's embrace. The leather boots and an Antivan longbow. Made from a Venadol. Interesting. So this dude's longbow is made from a tree that people worship in the alienages. Well, I have a vested interest in talking to you. You might actually have a chance of getting out of this alive, whoever you are.
if it isn't the great hero, conqueror of the Blight and vanquisher of all evil. Aren't you supposed to be 10 feet tall with lightning bolts shooting out of your eyes?
The Darkspawn probably thinks so.
Somehow I just thought that my father's murderer would be, more impressive. I am Nathaniel Howe. My family owned these lands until you showed up. Do you even remember my father?
How could I forget? Your father brought his end on himself.
My father served the hero of Riverdane and fought against the Orlesians, yet our family lost everything. I came here. I thought I was going to try to kill you, to lay a trap for you. But then I realized I just wanted to reclaim some of my family's things. It's all I have left.
Just how much do you know about your father?
If you're asking whether I knew what he was up to, the answer is no. I was squired in the Free Marches. Look, I don't know what happened with the Kuzlans. It sounds like it was horrible. The entire war was. Whatever my father did, however, shouldn't harm my whole family. The Howes are pariahs now. Those of us left. It's all thanks to you. And now you get to decide my fate. Ha! Ironic, isn't it?
Now, let's be clear. What happened to the Kuzlans has absolutely nothing to do with the Darkspawn War. That was done before the Battle of Ostagar, and that's all down to Howe's little envy and jealousy, which clearly still runs in this guy, too. Nathaniel still feels some of that. Now, I can sympathize a little with the fact that his sons and whoever else was there might not have been privy to things, and they do get punished on his behalf. That's kind of just the way it works, so... Let's see. I understand we had trouble capturing you.
I'm not without skills. My time abroad wasn't spent chasing skirts and drinking wine.
Your family only has itself to blame for its troubles.
The house served Ferelden for 12 generations. My ancestors served under King Callenhad. And now it's all lost. So go ahead and do what you're going to do.
You mean your family served Ferelden for 12 generations after they turned code and joined Orle? My family is the reason your family weren't on the side of the Orlesians, because they lost a battle against us. Let's not pretend that the Howes have some grand lineage in Ferelden where they've always been loyal to the throne. They were traitors back then, too. Do you really hate me so much?
The Darkspawn are a menace. If it weren't for the Blight, maybe my father would never have done what he did. But I can't do anything about them, can I? There's just you and the Grey Wardens here in my home.
The only reason Howe never would have done what he did if there wasn't a Blight, because he was too much of a coward to fight for it fairly. He would have never challenged our father in one-on-one combat. Of course, everything that he does is done in the safety of cowardice. Treachery in the middle of the night, poisons, knives in the back from the shadows. That's how Howe operated. I can't say anything about his son here, I don't know him, and it seems like at least this guy wasn't by Howe's side, so it's not like we can put any of the blame on him. Perhaps you should work to redeem your name.
You're right. I'll go join King Alistair's service immediately. He'd be certain to give a Howe another chance.
You'd be surprised, actually. What will you do if I let you go?
If you let me go, I don't know. I only came back to Ferelden a month ago. If you let me go, I'll probably come back here. You might not catch me next time.
You're not doing yourself any favors, are you?
I could lie, if you prefer.
That's a fair point. I've decided what to do with you.
Already? Good.
I brought the Seneschal for you, Commander.
I see you've spoken to our guest. Quite the handful, isn't he? Have you decided what's to be done with him?
I have. Did you know this was Nathaniel Howe?
A Howe? He figures that they would turn up again. The Howes are implacable enemies, Commander.
I wish to invoke the right of conscription.
You what?
I'm sorry, Commander. The right of conscription? On the prisoner?
No, absolutely not. Hang me first.
You don't think this is better than dying?
Hard to say. You like having Grey Wardens who want you dead?
Some of my best friends have wanted me dead.
I can't decide if this is a vote of confidence or punishment.
Both.
An interesting decision, Commander. Come with me, sir. We'll see if you survive the joining.
We're in the middle of a darkspawn threat. We need all the wardens we can get, and he needs to redeem his family name.
From this moment forth, seems like a good compromise. Nathaniel Howe, you are a Grey Warden.
The moment of truth.
It's not also lost on me that Howe is probably tending in his grave even extra now that the order he tried to have assassinated out of Ferelden, his son now belongs to them.
The Howe is stronger than I expected. For better or for worse, he will live.
I'm not surprised. Seems like a hardy man. Alrighty, and that is another companion taken care of. Now, before we get to any of this stuff,
Yes.
We are going to give Howe some equipment. And you did also see that I forgot one little piece of loot down here. So, in supplies, we have a soap on a rope and an elf root. But there's a lot of unique gifts in Awakening that we can give our companions to get their approval ratings up. Unfortunately, we did burn all the ones from Origins, but if you do import them into this, you can also burn them too. Right, Nathaniel, let's give you something. Right, now let's deal with some of these level ups. I guess we will do what we were doing before, so I'll do 2 dexterity and 1 willpower. The next time I'll do 2 cunning, 1 willpower, and we'll just go up the line. Anders. What is battle mage? Specialization bonus, 2 magic, minor combat health regeneration. Already sounds pretty good. Some mages specialize in spells that permit them to engage in combat from afar. Battle mages, by contrast, prefer to wade into the fray alongside their blade-wielding companions, close enough to read the fear in their opponent's eyes. Their spells primarily concern personal preservation, as well as control of the elements in their immediate surroundings. You already have Spirit Healer. I'm actually going to hold until we find Keeper, wherever we're going to find that. Okay. So, let me just make sure real fast that our vanilla line here is all good. We do want Vulnerability Hex. We're going to give him that. Put that in his tactics right now, actually. Do we have anything? He doesn't have tactic slots, so we're going to skip that for now. We'll come back to that. Now, Ogryn, my boy. We're going to save you a specialization point too, actually. We will go ahead and give you some more sword and board abilities, though. You definitely need them. We do need to work on up to shield mastery. Let's give him bash right now. Just give him like a little knockdown effect that he can use. This when I micro him. And crotchety bastard, aren't you, huh? Right, so we already know what we're doing here. He came with Assassin, which is good. We're definitely going to give him Bard. And now we can either give him Duelist or he can be a Shadow like us. Duelist is 2 dexterity, 1 damage per hit, and this is 1 dexterity, 5 attack. Let's give him Shadow too. And of course, we're going to bump up your tactics so you can actually use some of this stuff. Just max your tactic slots out, actually. And I'll give you some survival. Right, now you're going to go all the way up on the Assassin Tree. You're going to go all the way up to Song of Courage. You don't need Captivating. I'm the resident lockpicker, so we're not going to need that from you. We are going to need from you is your range tree. You don't have the dex for that. That'll do for now. Nathaniel Howe. If you had told me that there was going to be a Howe at my Grey Warden party at the end of Origins, I would not have believed you, but alas, here we are. Alright, now let's take a look around. Investigate the vigil a little.
Seneschal Verrall is ready for you in the throne room, Commander. Your vassals await.
Are there any messages for me?
Just give me a moment.
There is not. We will take care of that, but not just yet. Dworkin Glavonak.
I emptied out my stores blasting those darkspawn. Once we're done with repairs, some of our we should best talk. Customers,
and they need this us. Sounds very familiar to us, of course.
This place is so drab, it offends my sensibilities.
Ho ho, Haran.
Trust they preserve me. Ah, Warden Commander, I represent Master Wade, the finest...
And bloody coldest. I can't feel my fingers.
Finest armorer in Denerim. I thought, well, we thought that you might have need of an armorer.
I certainly do. Master Wade, I remember you. The Drakescale armor, right?
My one glittering moment. The highlight of my career. And now I'm stuck at Turnip Keep.
Vigil's Keep.
Turnip Vigil. Keep.
Sorry, Warden Commander. You know how he gets.
Indeed I do. Genius is often on the other side of the coin of madness. What brings you here?
This is a temporary relocation. The Darkspawn are most active around Amaranthine. We thought we could help.
Good man.
And I suppose the money the Crown paid us had nothing to do with it? Shh!
My men will need armor.
Providing arms and armor for common soldiers, oh, the indignity. If we are going to be so dreadfully plebeian, I don't suppose Amaranthine has any proper metal. Silverite? Viridium? Or are we back to bronze weapons? Stone clubs?
Wade has a point. He's happiest and fastest when presented with a challenge. If you come across any deposits of ore, let us know.
I will certainly keep that in mind.
Of course.
Master Wade makes the best masterwork armor and arms in the land, so if we can get some of that for our men, it's certainly gonna be good for us. Now, he does actually have some interesting things himself. He has the Guardian subclass. We'll definitely yank that. A Manual of Focus. Use this tome to allow the reader to reallocate. Oh, so we finally have a respec too. That's beautiful. We will deal with some of that, but not just yet. I mainly want to get myself acquainted with this place and kind of start all these quests. Baldric, Dworkin's cousin. They have the same last name.
Commander. So this is human construction, is it? My brother said you'd need a stonemason, but he didn't know the half of it.
Welcome to the Vigil.
You're too kind. The Darkspawn did a number on this keep of yours, but I suspect it was crumbling well before they showed up. Your seneschal gave me some fancy decree promising men and monies to fix the Vigil, but it's a paltry sum. I suppose it would be sufficient to reconstruct the walls to human standards. But who'd want that?
Well, I suppose we could always get it to Dwarven standards. They are the best stone workers in the land, right? What do you think we need? I might regret this, but what would it take to rebuild it right?
I'm not certain of the character of the stone in these parts, but we'd need more men for certain. Proper skilled men, not some starving dusters, right? Which all boils down to coin, really.
I can spare 80 sovereigns. This had better be worth it.
It will be, Warden. Good luck to anyone who tries to breach these walls. Ha!
So we just paid him a huge amount of money. That is the biggest sum of gold we have ever parted with in Dragon Age. So if this place isn't impenetrable, Samuel. I will be upset.
Groundskeeper Samuel! Is that you?
Who? Maker's breath. If it isn't little Nate. I'd know that face anywhere.
Groundskeeper, I am overjoyed that you stayed on. Please, do you know how my brother died? And my sister? I was in the Free Marches.
Your brother died in the war. And Lady Delilah, don't you know? She isn't dead, son. Not that I know of. Last I heard, she married a storekeep in Amaranthine. Don't know which one. Poor girl.
Did you hear that? My sister is alive.
I also heard this servant say poor girl for marrying somebody who's an honest worker and not a noble. That's a very interesting perspective coming from a servant. That's wonderful news.
Could we ask around the shops next time we're in Amaranthine?
We could take a look, yes.
Thank you. I would be interested to know just what happened to her.
Now again, this is a... kind of a complicated situation given who his father is, but I said in my Origins let's play I don't believe in the sins of the father. I'm not going to punish him just for being born to a bastard. So, we'll deal with things with Nathaniel as they progress. I'm not going to condemn him as soon as I meet him just because of his DNA. That's not how that's going to work. Good. No relation to Kitty from Unleash, right? Hungry little fella. Suppose we do need a pet. We don't have Duke with us anymore, so... There's one thing I'm a smidge grouchy about here, is we ended the game with a Mabari. Now, Mabari imprint on people for life. Where is my Mabari? We should also have the best boy. Duke should be with us. Where do we leave him in the palace? I can't see how our faithful warhound would decide to step away. And I know that he's not deceased because he's with us in later expansions. I want to know where my damn dog is. He should be here with me.
You don't always wear robes, do you?
Not when I'm naked, I don't.
I mean when you run from the circle. Robes would make you easy to spot.
Indeed.
So does the big I'm a mage sign around my neck.
I like to make it easy for the Templars.
Ah, so that's how it's going to be.
Yeah, Anders does have a tendency to rub people the wrong way, Nathaniel. You're a How and I like you more than him.
On it.
Look at that! Was Andraste really that much of a looker? Don't you think she would have been, I don't know, a barbarian?
You don't think barbarians can be attractive? Are you looking for realism? It's an icon.
Just wondering aloud. After all, Andraste did exist, didn't she? What would she have thought of the Circle of Magi? Forcing mages to fight demons, or be made tranquil?
She'd probably be confused by it.
No doubt you're right. Seems to me that Andraste counseled men to seek their own path to the Maker, but the Chantry uses her words as a reason to collar us just for being who we are.
It's not quite as simple as that. Mages are dangerous, and this, of course, is going to have a huge problem with that. I would prefer not to have started a political conversation with Anders, because given everything that he does in the future, it's very hard to separate the now from the then. But you can already see the bubblings up of his nonsense here. Then it's not quite as simple as collaring. Again, I always will bring Wynn up as the example to this, but the Mage Circle, she loves it. She thinks it offers protection, companionship, a brotherhood, a safe place to sleep and study and learn. Now, Anders can talk about all that he wants, running around with Templar entourages chasing him, spitting fireballs at Darkspawn, but he's a very dangerous man. And if somebody with this kind of powers gets a dangerous notion, he could do far more damage than a man like me. Like, our warden can put daggers in people. This mage can control kings, he can control emperors, he can summon demons, he can become an abomination. The level of risk of damage that one man can do when they have magic is vastly beyond anything that I can do. Mages don't get locked up. They get sent to a place to study. Now, granted, they do get locked up before they take their heroin, but that's because we need to make sure that they're not gonna be possessed, that they're not gonna turn into abominations. They won't summon demons. They won't use blood magic to control a king and get them to invade a foreign land. There's a lot of reasons why precautions are taken with the mages and why they're not just free to roam like they are in a D&D setting, for example. But it's not as simple as he's saying. Now, in general, the theory that he's saying about people being collared just for who you are. I don't think a mage is who you are. That's what you are. That's not who you are. Like, when you look at Wynn, that's not who she is. Who she is not a mage. What she is a mage. Who she is the moral compass, right? She's the nice woman that sacrificed the last segment of her life to defend Ferelden against the Blight. That's who she is. A mage is what she is. And I don't think you should be collared for being who you are, but for being what you are, there certainly has to be precautions. Of course, the dialogue doesn't let you get that complex with it, so now we're in a situation where we need to either say we completely agree with him, which we don't, or tell him to blow his entire opinion out of his ass, which... I mean, I also don't necessarily want to do. So... let's go ahead and, I guess, see what he has to say about this. But mages are dangerous.
Sure, but we're not dragons. We can think for ourselves, usually. Oh well. She's still quite a looker for a prophet. I'm just saying.
Yeah, so they can think for themselves until they get a little pressed and have a real bad day and start summoning rage demons and abominations. Then they don't do much thinking for themselves, do they, Anders? Not so black and white. And he knows it's not black and white. He's just... well, he's just Anders. Alright, guys. We've explored most of the keep at this point. We do have to talk to Sergeant Mavarales, or Mavolis. We'll go ahead and do that in the next episode. For now, that is going to be a wrap. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe, leave a like and a comment. If you want to support the cause and help improve the channel, as always, there is a tip link in the description below. Otherwise, stay tuned and I'll see you soon with more Dragon Age Awakening. Take care, everybody. Have a good day.